Well, welcome back to Dobbo's Fishing Adventures. And at last, I finally installed my portable diesel heater. As you can see, it's just one of the cheap Chinese ones off of eBay. Usual 5-litre tank or 4.5-litre tank. Everything's all self-contained. Comes with a remote. With an actual remote control as well, so that's good. So I've just finished installing it. Now I've done this in a way because I want it portable. I only want it over, you know, on here for sort of like the winter season, autumn, winter, bit into early spring, and that will do. So I'll only take it with me as and when I need it. So it's not on here permanently. Not that I've got the room to really fit one of these. I could have, to be fair, if I just bought the normal, the kit ones. But I just wanted one that's all self-contained. And to be fair, it's worked out brilliant. It really has. So the exhaust is going out the side of the boat here, through this hatch here. The exhaust outlet is in there, so it was easy to fit and install. Well, I'll just go over the side of the boat here. There's my outlet there. Now the exhaust is 48 inches, 4 foot long. I've lagged it all. I've used stainless cable ties. And the way I've done it is literally, so basically now all I've got to do is just lift this off, and there's my exhaust there. As I say, it's all properly lagged. The outlet is facing upwards, so I've got a nice big swan neck on it, so water can't go travel back up it and possibly flood the exhaust. I made some nice little noggins, I suppose, is whatever you like to call them. That's just steadies the unit while it's in place. And then when it's not in use, all I'll do is just push the exhaust out of the way and put the round hatch back in, so it's completely watertight again. I couldn't think of any other ideas how to do this, but to be fair, it's worked out really well. I'm pleased with it. All I've got to do now is just get a strap put over it. I've got a cover being made for the unit, so when I'm washing down, it's not gonna go over the heater itself. But yeah, so that's it really. It's the wiring, it's all 12 volt obviously, but I've used a 240 Hubble socket and outlet, all completely watertight, which I did fit when I fitted me other screen earlier in the year. I think it was February or March, I can't remember. So basically that unscrews, pulls out, and that's it. So basically I haven't used the earth on either end, so it's just got pos and egg. Now it came with a 15 amp blade fuse. I'll just move this out of the way so I can show you that. Once again, this was all installed earlier in the year. That's my other HS5 there for me forward screen and autopilot. But yeah, so it's just a simple blade fuse holder, and it's a 15 amp. So I've now got a few spare 15 amps in case it blows. Can't see it ever blowing, but you never know. So I've got spare blade fuses for everything. So it's nice and simple. I was toying with the idea of putting the exhaust a bit further forward, but then I realised I did have that round hatch in the side of the boat to get those extra rod holders on there, and I thought, oh, I wonder if it will fit, and it literally just fitted. Now, I've taken pictures of that, which I'll add at the end of the video. So the unit itself, I paid, I think it was $119.99, so that was the cheapest back then that I can find. And now I've looked since then, the square one like that, not the tall narrow unit, this one here, it's roughly about $99.99 now. But at the time, that was the cheapest I could find, this particular one. As I said, I didn't want the tall one. This is a lot more steady for my particular use. Ordered it, had it within 5 days. Not from China, obviously it's UK stock, but it 100% is a China diesel heater. And even this unit, it comes with the exhaust, various outlets, clips, hoses. Comes with everything you need to set this up, more of a permanent sort of thing. But as I say, I wanted this removable. So I think, touch wood, it's all good. I haven't run it up yet. I've literally just cut everything in. I've run it up before when I first got it, just to play around with it. I did change the wire that came with it to a much heavier duty rubber one, because it was only just literally two 2.5 cables, but I've extended all these out the back of the unit, and as I say, it's gone to this Hubble socket. Didn't take me long. I mean, I'm a boat builder anyway, to be honest, so it literally took me to sort all this out an hour and a half max. But if you're doing it with just the heater unit, it will take you longer, because you've got to mount everything, find somewhere to position the fuel tank, you know, wherever it's convenient. If I had a larger boat, to be fair, I would go down that route. But where I haven't got a larger boat, this is the ideal solution. So I think I'll just reconnect the exhaust, and let's fire her up, see what it's doing. Right, the exhaust is connected, I've got the power on. Unfortunately, the LCD display on here isn't that powerful, but I can just about, so it's literally on. That's it, the fan's just started up now. Can you see? Can't really see the... there we go. So the fan is all operating, so it's going through the startup cycle. In a few seconds the fuel pump will start. See if we can see there we go, that's a bit better. There we go. Hope you should be able to hear that. That's the fuel pump started, so what was about a minute from pressing on. So she's now pumping fuel into the element, into the burner. Thank you. pump's just started to increase a bit more. Yep. There we go, the pump's really increased now. There's a slight bit of heat. So as you can see, my exhaust is connected there, all stainless cable ties, which is a dead must. Please don't use plastic cable ties because they won't last seconds. Just trust me, it will get red hot. And the only other thing I would say with this, I haven't done it yet myself, but I will do. Oh, she's kicking now. There we go, there's a bit of smoke coming out now. But that disappears, condensation, that will disappear in a minute. So I've got this setting on low at the moment. What will happen is, it runs on full blast for a few minutes and then it cuts back down to the setting that you've got it on. I mean, that's lovely and warm at the moment. That is beautiful. Yeah, what was I saying? The fuel line. It's almost, well, it is. It's like a fish tank. You know when you put an air stone in for a fish tank? It's that green. They use that as a fuel line. I don't know if I'm going to change that or not. I think I will change it. To me, it's not a very good idea. They use it as a cheap solution. I'm not being funny. That's why these heaters are cheap. I mean, I've fitted plenty of Webastos, Everspatchers, Makunis. I've fitted them all in 30 plus years of boat building. But I have to say, time will tell, but I think these are as good as. I mean, that's really, really, that's lovely now. That's, as I would say, very toasty. But that will cut down in a minute, back to the lowest setting. Now this is an 8K heater, so really it's one of the bigger ones you can get. I thought, well, I'll get the maximum. There it goes, it's just starting to cut down now, going back to my original setting. But I thought I'd get the maximum one because at the end of the day, you just turn it down, put it on the lower setting for heat. There you go. Now she's cutting back. The fuel pump is going a little bit slower now. You can hear the pump just clicking away, but at less rate. So that's good. That's all working really well. I mean, that's warm. You can get an additional that clips into there, like fascia, but with four smaller outlets. But I certainly don't need that. It's just literally just heating up in my canopy. Now that's really dropped down now. Have a look outside here if I can without disturbing any of the video. And that exhaust is lovely. It's not overly hot, so that's good, but then I am on the lower setting. Brilliant. So that's worked out really well so far. just have a listen. So that fuel pump in there, it's gone really slow because that's on the lowest setting now. So let me just go up. Let me go up now to the maximum setting. Right, that's 3. 4 point something. 5. 5.5 that's gone to. So now the fuel pump has increased. The clicking you can hear has gone faster, so it's now pumping more fuel to the burner. The fan's increasing. And the heat is certainly increasing. So you've got, you can set time on it, a timer. There's various fault settings that come in the manual. The manual, you can tell it's been translated from Chinese to English. Some of the wording's quite funny on it, the sentences. Cool, I can't even put, I'm about 4 inches away there and there's no way I'll keep my fingers there. Now that is pumping really fast now. The air is coming out really, really fast. And as I say, all I've got is an open canopy. Just like some of you would have an open wheelhouse. It's a canopy, it's exactly the same. I've got this generally, if you know, if you're cod fishing or any sort of type of winter fishing, your hands do get cold. So I can warm this up, I can leave it on. I've got 2 batteries, I've got a start and a half battery. It will last without, on the battery, hours and hours. Certainly more than enough for your day fishing. But then I can parallel both batteries up if it does drink a bit much. So I've got no worries there on ever starting the engine, so that's good. Oh, that is. Now what am I there? I'm probably about nearly 10 inches away there and I can barely keep my hand there. Yeah, that's quite hot. So, if I go back on the settings, I'm gonna now decrease it. 3, there's 3. Let me get back down to 1.6. So that now will start decreasing. The fuel pump will get slower because it doesn't require the amount of diesel to the burner. On the opposite side of the unit here, it's got a fuel gauge, or it's got a sight glass so you can see how much fuel you've got in the little tank there. There you go, it's decreasing again now. Pump is just starting to, what I'll do is I'll get down to this when it goes to the lower setting and then we'll see what it's like turning it off. But one thing you must do when you turn it off, literally let it run it through its cycle, because if you don't, the heat that's still expelled in the burner, you'll just burn out the element. So you must properly turn this down, otherwise it'll just, you'll blow out, not, you'll just burn it all out. And that will be the same with any of the high-end ever spatchers. It's exactly the same. You must go through the cycle. So if you can hear now, that it's gone from fast to slow. Now I'm on the slowest one, which is 1.6. And that's just a nice heat to have there. You can hold your hand there for a few seconds, lovely. Whereas back here, on full blast, I couldn't even hold my hand there. So that's good. Right, to turn this off, if I remember rightly, let's have a look. Off. keep it on for about 3 seconds, the off flashes, and there you go, now it will go off on the turn off cycle, which is basically cooling all the element down before it completely powers off. Yeah, with well, I have to say, I'm bloody impressed with that. So if you're thinking about installing one, 100% go for it. But as I say, follow the instructions. They are easy, but it wouldn't take much to cock it up. Maybe not the unit, but potentially your boat. Oh, there we go. Can you hear that? It's just coughing now, where it's just burning off the last of the diesel that's in the element. That shows you the fan speed will be dropping, and then basically it just powers down. So there you go, hope that's been useful, but as I say, please follow the instructions. You have to follow the instructions, because although, yeah, you might damage the unit, you've got to work out, you know, where you're going to put something hot, your exhaust, make sure it's nowhere near flammable, because trust me, that exhaust is red hot. So it wouldn't take much to melt any plastics that's in your boat or anything. So please just use a bit of common sense when fitting the actual thing. There we go, the fuel pump's now completely stopped. It's now going through the cycle now. Look at that, I can even put my hand right in there now. So it's just cool, a cool hot air coming out now. Almost tepid. And this will just go down to shut off. Well, I hope that's been helpful. That's my latest gadget, so to speak, I'll put on the boat, but there will be a new one coming sort of like January, February, hopefully. I'll keep you informed on that. That's something to do with more electronics, but I'm not going to say anything now. If you've liked what you've seen, please like and subscribe to my channel, Dobbo's Fishing Adventures. I'm well impressed. Happy days.